Hi guys, thanks for tuning in to another video on ForgottenWeapons.com. I'm Ian McCollum, and I'm here today at the Rock Island Auction Company taking a look at a pistol, yes, but more importantly, a holster that they are selling in their upcoming September of 2018 premiere auction. And what makes this cool is, well, there were holster stock combinations for a lot of automatic pistols, basically all the automatic pistols made up until about the 1920s. This was an accessory, an option. Not a lot of people necessarily bought them, but almost every company offered them. Beretta offered them, Colt offered them, you could get them for Lugers, you could get them for Mausers, you could get them for a lot of the other developmental guns, Mannlichers, Bergmanns. Everything out there basically had some sort of factory holster stock. Of course, the most common one everyone's familiar with is that wooden shoulder stock holster combination for the broom handle Mauser. Now, the Luger is a little bit unusual in that there are a bunch of different stock options that were developed, and almost all of them failed miserably to be commercial successes, and this is no exception. So this is a holster made by the Ideal Holster Company. It was actually patented by a guy named Ross Phillips. He was an American living in Los Angeles, and he patented this really early. September of 1901, he applied for a patent on this guy, and that was like with less than 2 years after the Luger actually appeared on the market. Now, his patent wasn't just for Lugers, and the holsters weren't just made for Lugers. He also made a version of this for Colt and Smith & Wesson revolvers. But we're looking at the Luger one here today, because everyone loves Lugers. Now, to my mind, I've seen a couple different types of Luger holster, everything from the very simple German military flat board stock to the Benke Thiemann, which is this really weird sheet metal folding contraption. This one's pretty much a contraption as well, but I think it's really cool. I think it's the neatest of all of these things. So let's take a closer look at this. All right, let's start with this just as a holster. You can see we've got a nice big spring steel belt clip here. There is this metal framework, which is all stock stuff. We'll get to that. And then the inside is this nice supple leather holster. So slide the pistol in there. Got a couple little cutouts for the toggle knobs. This doesn't have any positive retention. This is designed so that this spring steel component here puts enough tension on the pistol to hold it in place. And you can see it's not going to come out. It's reasonably tight in there. It'll work just fine. Also interesting to note that you can take this belt clip off. So if I look on this side, there's these two keyholes, a locking tab there, and then this bracket. Well, this sheet metal assembly, it's one piece just bent into shape, the nose of it sits under that bracket, and then there are two keyed locking plugs basically that lock it into the side. If you lift up this tab here, you can slide the whole thing off and flip it over and make it a left-handed holster. Now, they didn't do this to accommodate left-handed shooters. I mean, good heavens, in 1902 you didn't shoot left-handed. They did this because the cavalry at the time actually wore their pistols on as if they were left-handed, because they had sabers on the other side, and the saber was more important than the pistol. So Phillips decided to design this thing, or the Ideal Holster Company that was making it, decided to design it so that you could wear it either way if you wanted to, you know, do the tactical military thing and wear it left-handed. All right, now to the cool part, which is how it works as a shoulder stock. You've got these two hooks on the top and two hooks on the bottom, and these lock into specialty grips that came with the holster. So these look like Luger grips on the outside, but when we flip them over, we've got these big metal plates. These grips are proprietary. If you bought one of these holsters for, say, a Smith & Wesson revolver, it would come with a proprietary set of Smith & Wesson grips. What you do here is you actually have a couple little slots in the back of the grip, and those slide, well, the holster slides into those. Now, when we open this up, we're going to extend it so it gets long enough to use as a stock. You push this little button in, and then you can extend this out. Note what's happening right here. The angle, there are pivot points in all of this. So there's a pivot here and a pivot down here. And this pivoting part is connected to the hook. So as we extend this, the angles here all change, and what this is actually doing is taking this bottom hook and opening it up like that. When it's fully extended, it locks into place. You've got two little locking tabs here, and in order to close it, you have to push them both in and then Close, there we go, and then close that. So it's really easy to get open. You've only got one tab to push to open it, but then it locks open nice and securely. And what you've done when you lock it open is you've actually rotated these bottom hooks far enough to securely lock the stock into the metal plates in these specialty grips. All right, let's go ahead and try it out. I've got a Luger here with these special grip panels already on there. So I'm gonna put the top hooks in and then rotate it down. And this locks nicely, except you can still lift the thing up and take it out. So let's do that, and then we'll push the button and expand and click. It's in place, and now this is a really sturdy, stable, locked in place stock. It leaves the grip safety accessible here. So put your hand around, you still have to depress the grip safety. Probably the biggest complaint about this is going to be the shoulder rest, which, well, there isn't a shoulder rest. You're basically resting your shoulder on these two basically kind of sharp pieces of sheet metal. And this would be very uncomfortable if this were not just a 9mm pistol. Because it is just a 9mm pistol, it has basically no effective recoil, and this isn't really a big deal. It's not as comfortable as it could be, but the shape is right. It's just these are really narrow little pieces of metal. So this actually works. This thing is really pretty slick. Then when you want to take it off, you depress both of these buttons all the way in, slide it forward, lift it off just like that. Then you can go back to holstering your pistol, drop it down onto your belt, and away you go. The only marking on here is patents pending, lightly stamped in the sheet metal right there. Now there isn't a lot of history to tell you about these because, well, they were a commercial failure. Enough people couldn't justify paying for a holster stock like this. Most people weren't going to actually make much use of it. And what's interesting is Phillips applied for the patent on this in 1901. It wasn't granted until 1904. That's pretty typical. However, all of the known examples are marked patent pending, which really does suggest that none of them were being made after 1904, or else you'd think they would have marked them with the actual patent number. Now, this gets a little bit weird because there is at least one known example made for a long-barreled Luger, and long-barreled Lugers weren't even available until like 1906. So it may not be quite as simple as made him in 1901, went out of business in 1903, and then got his patent after this whole project was over. It may be that someone tried to restart this and made a small number for long-barreled guns. At any rate, we can be pretty sure that this was a commercial failure, probably not manufactured after 1904. And these are pretty rare to find on the market today, so I thought it'd be really cool to show you this one. Just the mechanics and the geometry and the fact that it actually kind of works makes this whole thing really remarkable and cool to me. Hopefully you guys agree. Thanks for watching. And if you're interested in this yourself, of course it is being sold at the Rock Island Auction Company. So you can check them out and see everything that they have. Thanks for watching.